Okay, welcome to part four of my series on Python for stock analysis. And you can find links for the first three parts in the description of this video. You can also find a link to the GitHub repository where I'm sending all the code. Okay, so in those first three videos, we sort of dealt with how can you get a list of securities, how can you filter that list of securities, and then how do you download data, right? So we downloaded it into CSV files here, and we're sort of storing it in a folder system in this same folder that I'm working in. All right, so in this video, what we're going to do is take that downloaded data and we're going to extract just the closing price column out of the file. All right, and you can extract any column or columns that you want. I'm just going to get the closing price. Okay, so I sort of started this already, so we're going to call it get closing prices. We're going to have to point at a folder, right? And I, set a default here for data files. All right, and then we're going to have to choose whether or not we want the close or the adjusted close. All right, so I think you can make arguments for both. A lot of people like to work with adjusted close. I tend to like to work with close because I can compare that to the open, low, and high. And you can't really do that with adjusted close. But yes, there are certain places where you need adjusted close. So our function will handle that. But just as the default, we're going to get the close column. All right. So next thing I'm going to do is read all of the valid files in the folder that I'm interested in. All right. And when I save this, I'm going to save it out to a file that starts with a zero. All right. And so if I want to come back here and run this again, I want to skip that file. All right. So this is just a comprehension and to make sure I just read the files that I'm interested in. All right. And so next thing I'm going to do is set up a data frame. Okay. And I'm just going to make it empty. And then, we're going to loop through all those files that we just read into that comprehension. All right. So for file and files here. All right. And then the first thing we're going to do is see, did we switch this adjusted close to true? So that's just going to be if adjusted close. All right. So when that happens, right, I'm going to make a temporary data frame. It's going to dig it inside a Pandas data frame here. And that's going to come from a Pandas read CSV. All right. And then the read CSV is going to be the folder and then the file. Okay, and let's see what else I'm going to do. I'm going to set an index column here. All right, and that's just going to be the date column. All right, if I don't do this, I'm going to get a an integer-based index. All right, so I want the date, and then I want, right, we're saying that adjusted close has been toggled to true, so I want that adjusted close column. All right. And then, the reason why I'm sticking it inside or forcing it to be a data frame here is because when I read a CSV and I just get a single column, Pandas makes it a series. And I want to rename the column. And, well, series don't have named column. So I need it to be a data frame. All right. So I'm going to change adjusted close to the ticker symbol. Okay. So going to be data frame dot rename. All right. And then it's going to be columns. And then, all right. And then we'll just get everything except for the, right, the file extension. All right. We need to do that in place. Okay. So this is what happens when, right, that is toggled to true on the function call. All right. And then if not, it must be the close column that we're interested in. And that's pretty much the same. Right, I'll just copy this and make a couple of changes. All right, so instead of adjusted close, it's just close. And this is also close. All right, so now we have the appropriate column of data. We want to stick that inside this data frame. And okay, the first time through, it's going to be empty. And so we're just going to replace closes with this temporary data frame. All right, so if closes, all right, we're going to say closes equals the data frame. All right, and then otherwise, right, we're going to concatenate on the new process data frame onto the closes data frame. All right, and we're going to have to tell it to do it along the axis one. Okay, so now we have, right, basically cycled through all the files in here, right, got the either the closing column or the adjusted closing column, put it in a data frame, and so then the only thing left to do here is to return that data frame. All right, actually, I'm going to do a couple of things here. I'm going to write it out to a file, like I said at the beginning. All right, but by returning it, you can immediately use it without going through the additional step of, okay, reading the close file, right? So by assigning this function call to a variable, you'll end up with a data frame with a whole bunch of closing prices in it, all right? But I am going to take closes as well and to CSV it. If you want, and I guess we could call it whatever the folder name is, closes. All right, but I'm just going to leave it like this. All right, and then let's test it and see if that works. Closing prices, and we're looking in mine. Okay, looks like it worked. There is the file, and yes, for both of those securities in there, it gave us just the closing price column. Okay, and then happened pretty fast. All right, let's see what happens if I call it on energy. Okay, again, that happens pretty fast too. And then, yeah, quite a bit more data there to deal with. All right, there were 21 files in that folder. Okay, so that's going to wrap it up for part four. In part five, we're going to calculate return data on some of these closing prices. So I'll see you there.